गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू लेसन नंबर 2 फ्रॉम योर बीहाइव बुक द साउंड ऑफ म्यूजिक द शहनाई ऑफ बिस्मिल्ला खान। उस्ताद बिस्मिल्ला खान द शहनाई मेस्ट्रियो अचीव्ड हिज सक्सेस थ्रू डिटर्मिनेशन हार्डवर्क एंड करेज। ही वॉज अ फेमस शहनाई प्लेयर। Shehnai is the improvised form of Pungi. Emperor Aurangzeb banned the playing of Pungi in the royal court because of its unpleasant sound. But it was revived by a barber, and again he played this instrument before the king. And everyone was very much impressed, and then Aurangzeb named this instrument Shehnai. Ustad Bismillah Khan was born on 21st March 1916 at Dumrao in Bihar, and he played Shehnai, and before him Shehnai was played in the courts, temples and weddings only. The credit goes to Ustad Bismillah Khan, who had brought Shehnai onto the classical stage. And when he was 3 years old, his mother took him to his maternal uncle's home in Banaras. There he was very much fascinated by his uncle Ali Baksh, who was employed to play Shehnai at the Vishnu temple at Varanasi. He always accompanied him, and when he went to practice on the bank of river Ganga, when he was 14 years old, he got a big break when the All India Radio in Lucknow in 1938 was started. And after that, he became an often heard Shehnai player on the radio. When India got freedom, he was the first Indian to greet the nation with his Shehnai. He played his Shehnai in front of Mahatma Gandhi and Jawaharlal Nehru. He had given many memorable performances, not only in India, in abroad also. And the King of Afghanistan was so impressed with his performance that he gifted him Persian carpet, and he named one of his auditorium after his name. Ustad Bismillah Khan was conferred with many awards. He was given Padam Shri, Padam Vibhushan, and in 2001 he was awarded India's highest civilian award, the Bharat Ratna. In spite of having travelled all over the world, he was fond of Banaras. He loved India and Banaras very much. One of his students told him to start a Shehnai school in the USA. He promised that he would recreate the replica of Banaras in United States of America. At this, he asked him if he would be able to take the river Ganga there as well. He loved India very much. Whenever he had to go abroad, he kept yearning to see India. Of course, his life was a perfect example of the rich cultural heritage of India. However, he was a Muslim, but he never discriminated between the Hindu and the Muslim. He liked to play the Shehnai at the Kashi Vishwanath temple. He breathed his last breath in Varanasi on 21st August 2006 when he was 91 year old. So no one can fulfill his loss. He was a great musician of our nation. I hope all of you have understood the lesson.